Byron, you can remember that game more for the rally towards the end or for being down 27 for looking at your starters?
Probably both. You know, I thought, you know, they just, I thought, you know, the Clippers played really well for three quarters. You know, and I thought that, you know, fourth quarter, obviously, our young guys did a heck of a job of, you know, cutting into the league and getting it back down to single digits to make it a game. So I probably remember a little bit of both.
Who did you see as the catalyst in the fourth?
Really, Marcelo.
How so?
His energy, leadership, trying to get guys where they need to be. And just the fact that, you know, everybody that plays with him knows he's going to, you know, try to find the open guy. You know, he never tries to really create for himself. You know, so I thought our spacing was much better. You know, he was able to make some plays. Our defense was much better. Then when we got our defense going, we were able to get up and down the floor a little bit more. But I thought Marcelo was a big reason for that.
What did you make of D'Angelo?
I thought he was pretty good. You know, I thought he had some little good moments, and I thought he had some moments defensively where he was just kind of not there. You know, and again, you know, we made a bunch of mental mistakes, you know, as I just talked to him about, you know, or just sometimes our lack of focus just, you know, boggles my mind. And we can make a change defensively and go out and we still mess it up, you know, and that's something that just shouldn't happen.
Do you put it largely on him because he's the point guard? Or is
that just team one? No, that's team one. I mean, you know, if we make a change for, you know, our point guards or guards in general on a special coverage, you know, and he doesn't get in it or they don't get in it and the bigs don't get in it, it's not just one person. It's normally a team thing.
How'd you make a decision not to put Kobe back in?
Well, at that particular time, when it got to about the 6-minute mark, he had been sitting there for a while. I wasn't about to put him back in then. Pretty easy decision, to be honest with you.
What was your opinion of Kobe Bryant's performance tonight?
I thought Kobe was good. I mean, he's been good the last 10 games or so. He's been hitting his stride. I think his rhythm is, you know, is great right now. I think he feels real good, you know, from a physical standpoint. You know, so I'm, you know, real happy with the way he's playing. I'm pretty sure he's, you know, he's happy with how he's playing, you know, but, you know, I'm pretty sure he also thinks he can play better, which he probably can, but like I said, you know, he's playing at a different level right now than he was about a month ago.
Do you feel like you have nights where you got the starters that are doing a pretty good job, then the bench isn't doing well, and then vice versa, you have a night like tonight where you have the bench kind of picking up the slack, but you can't quite get them both to come together?
Yeah, that's what we're trying to get to. You know, where everybody can be a little bit more consistent. And you know, one of the main reasons I made the change with the starting lineup is because the starting lineup wasn't getting off to a good start. The bench was playing pretty well. And, you know, now the starting lineup, well, not today, but recently, have been getting off to a good start, and the bench hadn't been playing well. So tonight was a little bit of a reverse, you know, role play.
Are you thinking of changing it again soon?
Well, this is game 10. Right. And you know, like I said, it was going to be about 5-10 games or so. I'll think about it, but I'm really kind of inclined to kind of let this play out until the end of the year. Got three more games this month.
Byron, what did you think of Larry's put back in the first in the Clippers basket?
I thought that was kind of indicative of how this season has gone.